you. Connected with on the Inspiration Hour with Reverend Major Kwame Opoku.
Reverend Major Kwame Opoku, it's time to rise.
Okay, good afternoon, everybody. I said it to you that there's going to be a special man. I said it to you that I'm going to have a special guest this afternoon on my program, Inspiration Hour, for you. And so lucky the man is here. So to below, I'm going to introduce him to you. You know, we have Duke, different type of Duke. We have Judge Duke. Judge Duke is a pianist, but now the Duke that I have is a one of the gurus in the social media.
We love listening to the Inspiration Hour with Reverend Major Kwame Opoku. We love listening to the Inspiration Hour with Reverend Major Kwame Opoku.
You got it. So today is going to be just a little discussion for you guys, no? You gotta have the main man in the studio. The minister. Duke is in the house. And I'm going to introduce him to you, and he will introduce himself. So once again, we are back now. So this afternoon, I send my greetings to friends and loved ones. PK Ambrose, how are you doing? I hope we are doing well. May God bless you. Isaac Asimedu, one of the top pianists in this house. Let's listen to a song from Isaac Asimedu. I love his songs, you know. Let's listen to this track from Isaac Asimedu. That's a song from Isaac Asimedu.
Inspiration Hour with Reverend Major Kwame Opoku. It's time to rise.
That's a song from Isaac Asimedu for you. Continue to listen. The album title called Believe in Yourself.
connected with on the Inspiration Hour with Reverend Major Kwame Opoku.
So as I said to you, this is a song from Isaac Asmedu. PK Ambrose on bass guitar, Guiche on guitar, Paul Martin on saxophone.
Connected with on the Inspiration Hour with Reverend Major Kwame Opoku.
As I told you, this afternoon I am not here alone. I'm here with one of the legends when it comes to the social media things in music and everything. I mean, he's he knows what he's doing. The great man Duke is in the house. So Mr. Duke, I just wanted to push this microphone and hold the and then I need to do it from here. Okay. Yeah, you don't need to struggle because the microphones are more powerful than just let you say it goes out. Yeah, yeah. So I want to welcome you to ARC Radio this afternoon. Yeah, yeah. So how's everything?
Man, everything's great, man. Thank the Lord for. Mm-hmm.
I'm listening.
Man, I'm wonderful. Today is just a special day. I mean,
yeah. Just a flash, special, you know? Day
because it's just like. I can't believe myself, you know, after a long while, 7 years, I've gone all the way around from Ghana and back to here again. Once again, I'm here with Reverend Major Nana Opoku. He doesn't like that, he's gone. He doesn't like that, Nana, but I always put a Nana.
Anyway.
Reverend Major Kwame Opoku. Fantastic, a beautiful time.
Yeah. Oh, it's good. We give glory to God. Thank God for... God to bring you back again to wherever we are doing, because I know what you can do when it comes to the social media. You are one of the champions, you know, do videos, a lot of things that you can do, and you are artist also when it comes to artist drawing and
just
all these things.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know you are one of the guys that can do all those things. Yeah, so how is I know you're from Ghana. How? I mean, can you tell me something about the country? Oh, yeah, just from Ghana. So I just want to know, how is Ghana?
Fantastic. I mean, the atmosphere in Ghana. The atmosphere in Ghana. Let's close it.
Yeah, close the door. Sorry. Uh-huh.
Well, fantastic. The atmosphere in Ghana is so wonderful, man. You know, somebody would say in Ghana, you know, whether it is hot or cold, we're always happy. Hallelujah. Why? Because the country is what? It's engulfed with a sea of what? Christian programs here and then left and right. And well, if you go to some of our schools, even elementary schools,
okay,
on Sundays, we hear nothing but praise and worship. Ghana is a country of praise and worship.
Sometimes you can look into the camera.
Yeah. Ghana is a country of praise and worship. And as you know, well, we may not have it in abundance, but we're excited. No matter what the situation, no matter what, whether it's a political, negative atmosphere, where people don't have money, we're so excited to, you know, give praise. Yeah, that's what I can say about the country at the moment. Well, you know, there's all speculation going on as far as we are in a political, period at the moment.
Yeah, I know that this time, I don't know how to use political season or
well, it's a political season. In the sense that, you know, our politicians, our politicians boil down to, MVP and NDC.
Okay. So what is going on between MPP and NDC? What is going on?
We don't know. It's always the same. Always. You know, gimmicks.
Really?
You know, people can all kind of, you know, speculation here and there. You know, well, we don't know.
Very funny.
Which is which. And then it's hard time. We got to do away with this NDC and NPP.
NPP.
And we, then we believe in God. That God can bring somebody else, somebody new.
From
somebody,
where?
Somebody with, somebody with a new kind of ideas to, you know, whip these MVP and NDC people out of the way. Because I'm telling you, my brother, you know what? People are smiling, but down in their pocket, is there's a hole, you know?
What happened to that? Because I know some time ago, because of the galamsey and all these things, people said they got money. But one thing I realize is that, you see, the galamsey is destroying the country because all the land is going, because the chemicals and all this thing, they put it on the ground. A time will come that is going to, cancer will be available. Cancer is going to be something in this country and different type of sicknesses, because when the, you know, and people from their country, people from different countries come to Ghana and they will come for Galam, say that they need gold, you know, from the guy, and they will bring different type of chemical, you know, and all the rivers, all the rivers
saying.
And everything is gone. So do you think this, I think this government came to stop those kind of attitude, because we know that, you see, you eating today, you won't feel it, but your son or your daughter that is coming 20 years coming, things will happen very bad. I mean, so how do you think? So you see now, because I think when I asked people, they said because now the galamsey is not going on and all this because of that. So now people are broke; they don't have money in their pocket. So is that the way you are talking about? Or
well, I would say galamsey doesn't fit Ghanaians per se. Okay, well, Ghanaians in general, I mean, go on. On their usual duties, those who sell the market go to market, those who work at the banks go to their normal and everyday activities that they are used to, their routine.
So why is the problem coming?
So when you talk of galamsey, it may not be affected.
No, it's a part of it. I'm not saying it's the main cause, but
it may not be something so, you know, strongly attached to us, but as you said, the adverse effect.
So why do you think it's happening? Because listen, everything is still the same. Is that how you are saying?
Yeah, well, everything is still the same. But, you know, I will say the rate at which galamsey issue.
Now, ambulances are coming.
We'll come again?
Ambulances are coming now.
I don't understand.
To the country. What I'm trying to say that, I said, now they say there's an ambulance also. Because there are many villages and towns that even a woman want to deliver a baby, it make difficult. Some places they have to put them
of carrying the patient from A to B.
So my belief, and you know, I've been watching some things and I've been looking in European style and things. I can see that all these things that we are going through in Ghana happened in some of the European countries before, but now they advance. So we need to advance, but you see, change is something that. It's not easy for, especially when you are telling African people to change. It's difficult for them to do. So how do you?
Well, see.
How do you think?
I would say that when it comes to this political stuff, I always want to sway away from it because, you know, the issue here is we are not what we say we are. Because majorities are hungry. Because of that, what we know for sure that is very bad to our health, we close our eyes to it. Yeah, well, if you, a common example is the river Pra, when you're from, it's a midway between Cape Coast and Western region.
Okay.
Nobody should tell you, but you got to see the color of the water. They see the river, look at the color. It was what? It was green. I mean, you see that, when you are driving past, you could see how beautiful the water banks, the river banks is, and how fertile and gloomy it was, and we could see that this is a habitation for all aquatic species, fishes, and all those things. Okay. But right now,
you don't see
that. If you are passing by, you see that it's more like a muddy water. It's clay, and full of chemicals that are coming from the places where people mine. So, I think Major, it's better we talk about God and forget about this, Ghana politics, because
when you say you talk about God, who is God?
Man, we're talking about God who's
God created mankind as his own image. So,
choose a topic like the other day you were talking about the differences between.
Oh, I know, you said something, that's why. That's why I tried to say this. It's not. We are just, because you came from the country, so there's a lot of things I'm asking you.
I came from the country, I'm in the country, but I'm not in the country. Oh. The reason being that, I can't barcode according to my own size, because you see, African politics is stomach politics.
Okay.
It is a stomach politics because you see, whilst we know for sure that this is blue, we say it's green because we want something to go into our pocket, which we haven't worked hard for it. So it's a bribery and corruption, and exeterra is still in existence. And that is the reason why I'm not even interested to see, swear my eyes around to know what is going on in the country.
Yeah, but you're a watchman.
I'm a watchman, but I'm more interested.
You are in, ambassador.
Focusing on the things that will, help us to get to the kingdom of God.
Kingdom then, in which way? You see, listen, this is what sometimes people don't understand me. You listen to me. You see, we live in a community.
Yes.
You see, because it's not affecting me, I don't care about what is going on. You see, last I was leading prayer in the church, and I told the women that, listen, women, somebody's son or daughter has been stabbed. Mm-hmm. Because it's not your daughter, it's not your son, you don't care. Mm-hmm. But one thing I will tell you, that you don't know when or where that it will happen to your son or your daughter.
Definitely.
So if God put us as watchmen, we shouldn't say everything that goes, you say, or come for born in case or timbi. You see, we live in a place that things is going on because we are Christians. So we Christians, we don't. Yeah, but nobody, we are ambassadors.
Politically, what
is it serious?
What can I do? My voice doesn't reach anywhere. I'm not a politician.
Your voice is very stronger because you're a man of God.
All what I do is, concentrating on what the little things I can do.
For the country.
We can pray for the country.
You
can see that there are a bunch of jokers who call themselves leaders in Ghana per se.
I saw some a certain guy. He's a very young guy. I think I saw him in the scene. And the way he insulted great men and then elder people.
There's no need for us to insult them. If you don't have much to give, or if you cannot be of help, you just stay in and on the fence and look at what they are doing. You can do the little ones, little things by educating the young ones, teaching them that there's no need for us to count on rely on the politicians, but what? Going about to do the little things that you can do as a person. Yeah,
because somebody like you see the kind of work that you have, if you say you want to train people, you can get a lot of boys, because these days, all these guys need something to do. They need something that handiwork or things that they can use their brains and things to do.
Mm-hmm.
That you have it, that you can't
train. Well, Reverend Major,
yeah.
You see, what the country, Ghana, and Africa per se is lacking is nothing but what? Leaders.
That's the whole thing.
That's the main thing. Mm. We lack what? Leadership.
Right leaders.
You see, we lack leadership. Because that's what I said right from the beginning, that in African politics it's about stomach. You see, we are not thinking about the people as a whole. You just imagine, Kwame Nkrumah, for instance, died empty pocketed. He didn't have a bank account. You know that. More so, where he hailed from, which is Nkwafu, he didn't do anything over there. He was what? Ghana-centric, Africa-centric, and a global-centric. His desire was to be able to help Africa and Ghana as a whole to streamline to the right direction.
But I think some elder people are saying that.
So we're lacking leadership. Yeah. Because at the end of the day, you see, just imagine, you go to a house where there are no leadership. It will start right from home, where the house that is the mother is the father and a mother at the same time. Do you understand? So that's how it is.
Like a single parent thing, something
yeah,
like that.
Exactly. You see, we have all these ones going on. And you see, also, our education system is bad. Why is it bad? Ask yourself the question, why is it bad? Because we have been taught how to be able to memorize. Yeah, memorize the book, and you will be the best student. You see, but we have to think about equipping people to be able to do good things in their best capability, their best ability.
Mm.
You look over here, for instance, when you look at the schools in England, for instance, you will see that some students academically, they are not there. Okay. So, such students are put in a certain structure where it's like a training. You see, some of them learn how to lay bricks. Some of them go to the direction of what carpentry and joinery, and they do and learn it very well. They attain a wonderful skill that pay them off. You understand? But this is a country where in Africa and everywhere, you Ghana per se, where everything is what memorizing. You got to be able to memorize. You understand? If you memorize and do well, meaning it means that you are the best student.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
So, Major, I think to me. I'm not interested in, politics and political issues are there
in the country.
Yeah, as a whole. But I was interested in doing things of God, worshiping, equipping people to know what the potential they have,
mm-hmm.
the enormous potential God has placed in them.
Mm-hmm.
And to me, that is the best way. Because if you can group few people to understand things very well, they can also propagate the information. You understand it?
Yeah, okay. And how is the churches in Ghana?
Churches in Ghana.
As you are saying all these things to me about the political, when you go to the social media, you see the churches fighting, pastors fighting against among themselves.
Mm-hmm.
Now they are showing cars, showing houses instead of them to show. But souls are perishing, souls are dying, and all these things. We see all these things.
Well,
they say when you move 2 seconds, there's a church. All schools have turned into churches, but still.
Well, what I think fundamentally, there's something seriously wrong in the country. Something seriously, seriously, seriously wrong in the country because, look at the country. In general, Major, I'm very sure when we take the drivers, we have driver association. You see, when we talk about housing, we have housing association.
Okay.
We talk about even the leaders, the ladies in the market who sell, they have their leadership. Do you understand it? Association. So somebody cannot just wake up and pick himself and sit in a car and drive around, and they call themselves that they are drivers, or you understand. So, what I'm trying to say is the church issue is coming as a result of bad leadership once again. Because give you the license to become a pastor, or whatever, they're supposed to be a governing body. You understand?
Okay.
Who have to sit here that things are done properly? You see?
That's your opinion.
That's my opinion, because you need to be certified.
Mm-hmm.
Like what IMAC is doing. Yeah. IMAC were working with leaders. You see? In your book over here, I don't know if they can see.
Yeah,
IMAC is working with leadership. You understand? This is a Christian government body who are equipping and training people globally to learn the skills and the knowledge of the Bible to go out there to preach the word positively. And in so doing, you need to go under their training. Yeah. In so doing, you need to be trained properly. I mean, for the leaders to understand that you have gone through this, all their processes, before you be what you'll be entitled to have the mandate to go out there to preach the word of God. Do you understand it? So, to me, I think the country Ghana is supposed to do things like that. Because without that, this leadership training, you can't go out there and start preaching. You understand? Okay. You need to be licensed. Do you understand me?
Yeah,
do you understand? You need to be licensed. You need to be trained. You see, you need to have a certain manners. There's a saying that before when you go to the Accra Market Circle, you will see the fetish priest holding snakes, you see, doing all kind of wonders, you know. And these days when you go to the circle, you don't see them anymore. Why? Because all these people have realized that the best place and the best way to enrich yourself is to find yourself in a, what do you call it, in a nice suit and tie, and make sure you know some part of the Bible, and pass somewhere and get some spiritual powers to come and what? Display.
Okay.
You understand? Mm-hmm. So how come two men of God will just go out there and start fighting each other and displaying their skills? The money they have, their riches, their millions, you see, fighting for congregation, and sort of we propagating the gospel of Christ. You see? So it's all going down to leadership. Because I'm very sure we have what's called Christian leaders organization or something like that,
mm-hmm.
which certify people to be able to go out there to open churches. You see, if such organization, this such leadership, if they are efficient, okay, then this will not happen. They will be able to close down some of their, bogus, churches.
Bogus ones, okay.
Mm-hmm.
I think I heard something in the news that they were discussing something like that. Anyway, and how is the music in the church? Because you have a music, is how the music in the church?
Music in the church will always be the epitome of the church itself. I mean, when we talk about the church, the backbone of the church is the music,
mm-hmm.
where we can go out there to, start preaching the word of God. And without the music, the church would not be the church that we wanted
mm-hmm.
to see. So the church, the music has always been there. And so far, I can see the music ministry in the country, is taking its shape. So far, so good.
Okay, before then, let's listen to a song before we come back. And then.
We love listening to the Inspiration Hour with Reverend Major Kwame Opoku.
So these days, when you look at how things, is doing in the country, what I was saying, you see, there's a lot of albums coming out. Most of the gospel singers are releasing albums, and then. So do you think all these albums, have impact on the gospel in the church or something? Because some of the songs, when you listen to the release of the songs and things like that. Anyway, that's what I'm trying to ask something about. The music and the church. The gospel singers, are they, what they are doing, is it participating to the church or is it something that they are doing their own thing or something like that? That's the question that I was trying to ask you. That's why I say the music and the church, because some of the music in the church, when you're listening, anyway, is something different. So, but we can't complain too much and then say things too much. But as we are moving, there's a lot. The reason why I'm asking all these things are because, you know, where they come from the country and how music is moving there. Because I know you have a quality of music, style and everything. And I know you know some of the musicians, you have a studio. I know they come for pictures or... It's because some people they want to do designing albums. I know you do all these things. So how is it effective? Did people come more all the time? Because I think every month it can be more than 20 people launch album in Ghana, gospel and the secular. Did you work for, you work both?
No, I work with both.
You work with both, huh? So tell us something about that.
Well, I would say, you know, so far so good, because, you know, people are doing their best.
Mm-hmm.
You know, before, music was not, you know, seen the way it's been seen today.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, now, you just imagine, over the years, when somebody used to play, maybe he's an instrumentalist, we call them musicians. They are the musicians because they make the music come to reality. You see, somebody is a good guitarist, somebody may be a bassist, somebody be a good pianist in the church. That's what a person does to support the church. Then, somewhere along the line, you know, because the people spend all their time from morning to evening, you know, doing things of God, like, you know, when there's a Friday service, Thursday service, Sunday service, they're always there, supporting the vision of the church. So such people, mm-hmm. you know, we have to recognize them. But unfortunately, you know, they can tell mm-hmm. such a person to go and find a job. Someone to go and look for a job. But bear in mind that some people went to school,
mm-hmm.
basically, to study music. And so music is what they do from morning to evening. So such people need to be paid so that they can take good care of their families.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Now, here is the situation that the ordinary person who doesn't understand this kind of stuff is also in the church. So if you got to know that if such a person is being paid, they get furious.
Mm-hmm.
It's why would they use my tithe and offering to pay such a person? You gotta go and look for a job, you see? But it looks like it is changing.
Okay.
Because I'm very sure you have children who are highly endowed. You can see that their talent is in the music. What you can see that they don't even have time to play with their peers. But every now and then, you see them studying music, you know, practicing. So, you know, when a person finishes school with such a skill, what do you expect a person to work? Well, fortunately, some of them may end up working for the church. You see, helping the music aspect, that also helps us, is one of the ingredients that help the church growth. You see, you know, you yourself are a worshiper. And you know that without praise and worship, the church will be like a cemetery. Yeah, when the men of God are preaching, sometimes you see people are sleeping. But I'm telling you, when it's praise and worship, you see every hunk and dory standing and giving praise to God Almighty. You see, well, you ask a question about music in Ghana.
Okay.
See, the music in Ghana has taken a different shape. Why? Because now people are recognizing that music is a what? It's also somebody's what? Occupation. It's also somebody's what? A means of what? Getting something to put on the table for the family.
I think you said something. I noticed something that you said. You said sometimes if you sing in a church or play instruments, they expect you that pray for free and go and find work to do.
Mm-hmm.
But somebody also go to school of music. To come out, that is his skills, that is his study.
Exactly.
That is apart from music that giving us a gift, somebody also go to school to study also, or mm-hmm. even buy books. Some people didn't go to music school, but they buy books and things, you know, seminars and things for music, for them to understand what is music. You understand it? But so if you are in a church and the church expecting everybody to come and play for free, I don't think it's right. Because that is somebody's work, somebody's job, somebody's profession. Mm-hmm. That's why somebody also used to look at his family and things, you know. So some pastors or some churches understand this thing that we are talking about, but some people don't understand it. It depends, you know. I remember a church used about £60,000 mm-hmm. for about 10 years ago to buy equipment, mm-hmm. and they don't want to pay musicians. The church have £60,000 pounds at that time to buy a set of equipment to bring white men, call the white men, charge them big money. It's a black church, and they come and install it, everything for them. You understand it? But instead of them to find a musician, a proper musician or qualified musician or professionals to come and handle the equipment, for them to pay them, they said, "Oh, our children will pray." So what time your child will grow to come and learn music to be like me or like somebody before they come and pray? So before they know, all the equipment's getting spoiled because those who are handling it are not matured enough to handle it. You see, and it's God's money. It's God's money. They think to pay musician is wrong, but to when you are going to buy the equipment, did they give it to you for free? You use £60,000 to buy equipment, but to employ me to come and hold it, I'm a worshiper. I'm a Christian, but that is my profession. That is my work. That is what I do to live. So you can't tell me that because it's church, so
well,
I should come and
well,
then sing for free.
I like that point. You see, yeah. Just imagine. Let me talk about Ghana and Africa. These days, when you go to most churches, the song that they sing in most churches these days are not the songs that has been written in the hymn books over the years. Now, every church you go in Ghana, you will hear of Sonny Baru, the Nigerian lady Sinach, Neo Kai, Koda, Kofi Dianto, Joe Metal, the South Africans.
I'm coming.
Ada and Kosi. All these are the young, the youth
are coming. People
are not motivated. How would they be able to come out with the new songs, apart from with a hell song? You see, but our local guys are also doing wonderful with our music, with the music. Because you see, look at Sinach alone.
Yeah.
And
now
under her pastor, look at how she's been inspired to be able to write these wonderful songs. These days,
do you know why?
These days, her song. Sing some of her songs.
Yeah. No. Let me do this one. Okay. Mm-hmm. Let's listen to this song before mm-hmm. I present everything. Mm-hmm. I make a song ready that I'm going to play for her to sing. Mm-hmm. You know, there's a group called Krastafaris.
Okay.
Krastafaris are a group that they do reggae music, mm-hmm. but popular song like his songs and all these things. When you sing a song, when your song become hit.
Like I can see Bimpo.
Okay. Listen to this one. Mm. Listen to this one. You are saying something that I like it. Is it not a Snatch song?
Yeah.
Okay, listen.
We love listening to the Inspiration Hour with Reverend Major Kwame Opoku. Inspiration Hour with Reverend Major Kwame Opoku. You are here.
Okay, let's go back. Let's come back to the studio.
Our topic, yeah.
You see what you are saying. I just proved something for you. What you are saying for people to see what you are saying to, because the hymns, it's good to sing the hymns. But yes, we sing the hymns for so many years.
Yes.
That you see, the God that we are serving is not one way God.
Yes, because the
Bible says, "Sing a new song unto the Lord."
So hallelujah. Father,
we need. People of God, you see, they are inspired by the Holy Spirit.
Exactly.
Snatch and all these guys, Sonny Badu,
Koda,
all those guys.
That's it, all those guys.
Yes, it's God. They are inspired by God. So it's not one way that we are doing. We are not serving one way God, but we've been to a situation or been to a time that it's like, as you are saying, if somebody is doing music in the house of God, you see, they must take good care of the person, because God is very jealous about his people. People mm-hmm. like David.
Mm-hmm.
Why the Bible say David is a friend of God?
Yes.
David is a friend
of God.
Because
the Bible say they are new every morning. They are new every day.
Love. Come on.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
They are new every morning. So, see, every now and then, the angels of God comes in with many talents, and they will shower us with a lot of new music. So if people in the house of God who do music and don't do music full time are not taken care of, then where do we stand? Just imagine. Because some people, you know, they cannot do anything apart from worshiping.
Let me tell you one thing. I've seen something. Some pastors, they think they can sing. I know some pastors, when we are singing, they were studying us. You know, I know a pastor who, some time ago, he said, "Reverend," that I was not even ordained as a reverend minister. I was just a music evangelist. This man said, "I want you guys to teach me, to help me to know how to sing." Mm-hmm. Now he can sing 1, 2, 3, so he think he's a singer.
Mm-hmm.
"You are a prophet, I'm a singer." Listen, me, I don't want to call myself a prophet.
Mm-hmm.
Because God didn't call me as a prophet. But remember some time ago, prophetic unction come over me. But because I'm not a prophet, so I didn't use it. But I know that God called me as a psalmist. So that is my office. And being to a time, you see, some pastor think they can't be, so far as you are a pastor or God call you as a man of God, a prophet or whatever, doesn't mean you are a singer. Mm-hmm. I know some people have a lot of skills, but not all of them. And so they should give room to their musicians, their singers.
Well,
they should help them.
I'm talking about that. Even you yourself, you have wonderful songs that the whole world doesn't grasp it. The whole world doesn't know what is going around with Major. Major has got wonderful songs. I mean, there are your new song. The "Why You Be There," I mean, the one. Look out song. Can you play for the people out there to hear what you have?
I'll play. I'm going to do it.
It's Major.
You see,
so that, and you yourself, look at the number of songs that you have every day. God lay, put songs on
your
heart. You see, and all those songs, I mean, some of them haven't matured yet because what? You are not motivated. You understand? Because if the churches are ready to take our songs on, you see, then there will be more songs coming out. Yeah, Reverend Major.
You see, there is
one. You see, I had a first one. "Why You Be There," I mean, why? But I realize that what you've done right now is on a different level. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, listen to Reverend Major. You don't have the song? No, I have it. I want the people out there to hear your song.
The reason why I don't want to do that one is I'm working it out to bring it out.
Okay.
So, okay. But we are still trying to say, okay, let me drop some of my songs.
Yes.
I have different songs that I can drop some of my album. Okay, now we listen to a snatch song that somebody make it in reggae
Miracle music. Miracle Maker.
Yeah, that may make it reggae music. That's mm-hmm. very powerful. Okay, let's listen to this one. Okay, for my album. Let's see.
With on the Inspiration Hour with Reverend Major Kwame Opoku.
You play my song.
What we do is we before we finish the program we draw and see what we can do because the man that I'm talking to have a very nice album that we need to listen but so okay let's round up of the program. I think today is something that just a little thing that we want to talk. I just want to welcome you also from Africa, Ghana. Then I know what you can do and know where you are doing when it comes to the social media. All men of God, this man, if you want, whatever you want to do, talking about flyer, talking about whatever you want to do concerning social media, this man of God is ready to do it for you. And he's back. And we are tuning up to bring something out for you.
The youth out there that have talents, the giftings of writing songs, and you don't know where to go, you can contact me.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Put your telephone number.
Yeah, my telephone number is 07474118747. 07474118747. Hallelujah. If you have a talent, if you have the ability to sing, and you think, you know, you haven't been able to come out as a result of maybe frictions here and there, you can contact me. You can call me right after this program so that we'll be able to do the best that we can help you to do. You see, to be able to help you to tap the enormous potential God has placed in you so that you can use it to glorify the things of God. There are many out there who have talent, but they are sitting on it. I always say that the most richest place on planet Earth is the cemetery. Why? Because there that you will see untapped talent. Then you see talents that have gone were there. Listen to me. I don't know what you're going through or what you're about to do or what your plans what your plan is. But I want to tell you that you have certain talent in you that you need somebody to help you on earth to use it to glorify God. Look at a cemetery. 5 years, 3 years, 4 years, 800 years. Some of them didn't even tap that talent. Some of them were looking at the wrong direction. Some of them were thinking about something else. Are you in that right domain? Are you in the right domain? Are you at the place where God wants you to go to use what he has placed in your head to use it to glorify him? Well, you can contact me or Reverend Major Opoku Kwame Opoku, right? To be able to help you to unearth such talent that you have in you. If you want to act, you want to sing, you want to write, you want to learn how to design, you want to do computer gaming, 3D, what do you want to do? Come and see us. You'll be smiling.
That's good. Let's listen to this one.
Hour with Reverend Major Kwame Opoku. It's time to rise.
Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever.
from generation to generation, we worship you.
Love listening to the Inspiration Hour with Reverend Major Kwame Opoku.
You better believe me, oh God, like Jehovah, oh Jireh. Sammy tell them, say, my daddy is the king, so I am royalty. Oh, my daddy is the king, so that means I am royalty.
My daddy is the king, so I am royalty. This afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, my time is up. I just brought a friend, a good friend, a man that can help you, can be a blessing to your life, called Duke. And he's here to teach a lot of things. So what I'm trying to tell you is that you are a royalty guy, you know. Your dad is a king. So what I'm trying to tell you, I say, oh, keep on listening to ACK Radio. Your life will never be the same because we have a lot of packages for you. May God bless everyone. See you tomorrow. May God bless you.
So him clean me up, turn me round, lift me head, fix me crown, love me right, grace among me no last, no one wrong. Show me off, call me son, change my name, bless me song. Now the blessing can't turn down. So me have the most. My daddy is a king, so I am a royal.
Get on board Trumpet Radio. We're taking you closer to heaven. Get on board Trumpet Radio. We're taking you closer to heaven.
Okay, say goodbye to everyone. Facebook friends, may God bless you. YouTube friends, may God bless you. Those are watching me live on Facebook and live on YouTube. Tomorrow will be another day. If God permit, I'll come and serve you. May God bless you. Bye-bye.
And clean me up, turn me around.